Welcome to the iPod Classic Take Apart Guide. The Classic and the Video iPods are very similar. One of the main differences that's noticeable is that the front case is metal instead of plastic. If you look at the back of the iPod, like here, you can see the serial number and the model number. To open up the iPod, you need to get a small flat tool such as this putty knife and gently wedge it in between the front and back case to spread apart the two. Work your way around all the sides, gently separating the casing. Eventually, the case will begin to spread apart, and you can separate the back case from the front case. When the front and back case separate, you can then open it up just enough to unplug the battery cable. Use a small flat tool to lift up on the locking mechanism and then release the battery cable. Now flip down the hard drive and use a small flat tool to lift up the locking mechanism and unplug the hard drive cable. To remove the hard drive cable from the hard drive, gently push up on the locking mechanism and then pull on the hard drive cable. Now to unplug the headphone board assembly, take your small flat tool and gently lift up on the locking mechanism and then slide out the cable. Now to take out the battery. The battery is adhered to the back case, so take a flat tool and gently slide it underneath the battery and lift up. To remove the hold switch, there's two small Phillips screws that have to be removed. Once those two screws are removed, simply pull on the hold switch to remove it. Now to remove the headphone jack, there are also two small Phillips screws that have to be removed. Once those are removed, simply lift up on the headphone board to remove it. Now you can remove the two small bumpers at the bottom near the dock connector. Now there are three small Phillips screws located on each side of the frame. Remove these. Once those are removed, take a small flat tool and pry in between the frame and the front case to remove it. Continue to do this, working your way around the entire frame. Now you can lift up on the click wheel to remove the center button. And now to remove the LCD, take your small flat tool and lift up on the black locking mechanism, and then gently slide the LCD cable out. Then the LCD and the housing can be removed. Now to remove the logic board, there are two small Phillips screws located here. Once those are removed, flip over the logic board and gently press on it to remove it. Now to remove the click wheel. Take your flat tool and gently lift up on the locking mechanism. The rest of the cable is going to be adhered to the logic board, so gently take your flat tool and slide it underneath to remove it. Once the cable is separated from the logic board, it can easily be disconnected and removed.